Hi friends, welcome to the channel The Nurse. Here we are discussing about obstetrics and gynecology, nursing questions and answers. If you are not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe. Question starts now. First question, screen.
Obstetrics and gynecology, nursing questions and answers. If you are not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe. Question starts now. First question, during labor, session plus one indicate that the presenting parties during station plus one indicates that the presenting parties high in the false pelvis, on the perineum, slightly below the ischial spine, slightly above the ischial spine. Correct answer, slightly below the ischial spine. Station plus one indicates slightly below the ischial spine. Next question. Oral contraceptives are prescribed for a client. What side effects should the nurse inform the client might occur? Oral contraceptives are prescribed for a client. What side effects should the nurse inform the client might occur? Cervicitis, ovarian cyst, breakthrough bleeding, fibrocystic breast disease. Correct answer, breakthrough bleeding. Breakthrough bleeding commonly occurs when clients begin taking oral contraceptives. Breakthrough bleeding commonly occurs when clients begin taking oral contraceptive. It is mid-cycle bleeding, and if it persists, the dosage should be changed. It is mid-cycle bleeding, and if it persists, the dosage should be changed. So, breakthrough bleeding is a common side effect of the oral contraceptive. If it is persist, you need to change the dosage of the oral contraceptive. Next question. Menorrhagia means irregular menstruation, excessive bleeding during menstruation, bleeding between menstrual periods, painful menstruation. Correct answer, excessive bleeding during menstruation. Menorrhagia means excessive bleeding during menstruation. Next question. A histogram or histosalpingography or HSG is performed to determine whether there is a tubal obstruction. The nurse concludes that infertility caused by a defect in the tube is most often related to a histogram is performed to determine whether there is a tubal obstruction. The nurse concludes that infertility caused by a defect in the tube is most often related to a tubal injury, past infection, fibroid tumor, congenital anomaly. Correct answer is past infection. Past pelvic infection is most common cause of the tubal infertility. Past pelvic infection may result in tubal occlusion, most of which are caused by post-infection adhesion. Past pelvic infection may result in tubal occlusions, most of which are caused by post-infection adhesion. Next question. The nurse collecting data on reproductive system for a female patient is told that the patient has a vaginal discharge that is cottage cheese-like in appearance. The nurse recognizes this as a common sign of. The nurse collecting data on the reproductive system from a female patient is told that the patient has a vaginal discharge that a cottage cheese-like appearance. The nurse recognizes this as a common sign of. Pelvic inflammatory disease, Trichomonas vaginalis, atrophic vaginitis, Candida albicans infections. Correct answer is Candida albicans infections. Cottage cheese like appearance during vaginal discharge means Candida albicans infection. Next question. Following hysterectomy, the nurse assessing for abnormal bleeding would. Following hysterectomy, the nurse assessing for abnormal bleeding would record the number of perineal pads used, assess the vital signs every 8 hours, place the patient's bed in high folders position, apply an abdominal binder. Correct answer, record the number of perineal pads used. Next question, the nurse instructing a client on breast self-examination explains to the patients that the best time of the month to perform a breast self-examination is. The nurse instructing a client on breast self-examination or BSC explains to the patients that the best time of the month to perform a breast self-examination is before the menstrual period, during the menstrual period, after the menstrual period, or the first day of the month. Correct answer, after the menstrual period. The best time of the breast self-examination is after the menstrual period. Next question, a nurse is teaching a group of women about the side effects of different types of contraceptive. What is the most frequent side effects associated with the use of an intrauterine device? A nurse is teaching a group of women about the side effects of different types of contraceptive. What is the most frequent side effect associated with the use of an intrauterine device? A tubal pregnancy, a cap rupture of the uterus, an expulsion of the device, an excessive menstrual flow. Correct answer, an excessive menstrual flow. Subsequent to IUD insertion, there may be an excessive menstrual flow for several cycles. Because the IUD is a foreign body, there is an increase in the blood supply as a result of the inflammatory process. Subsequent to IUD insertion, there may be excessive menstrual flow for several cycles. Because the IUD is a foreign body, there is an increase in the blood supply as a result of the inflammatory process. Next question, a client asked the nurse about the most common problem associated with the use of intrauterine device. What should the nurse respond? A client asked a nurse about the most common problem associated with the use of an intrauterine device. What should the nurse respond? Perforation of the uterus, spontaneous device expulsion, discomfort associated with the coitus, development of vaginal infections. Correct answer is spontaneous device expulsion. So most common problem associated with the IUD insertion is spontaneous device expulsion. The IUD may cause irritability of the myometrium, inducing contraction of the uterus and expulsion of the device. The IUD may cause irritability of the myometrium, inducing contraction of the uterus and expulsion of the device. Next question, a nurse is teaching clients to determine the time of ovulation by taking the basal temperature. What change is expected to occur in basal temperature during ovulation? A nurse is teaching client to determine the time of ovulation by taking the basal temperature. What change is expected to occur in basal temperature during ovulation? Slight drop and then rises, sudden rise and then drops, marked rise and remain high, marked drop and remains lower. Correct answer is slight drop and then rises. During ovulation, there will be a body temperature, slight drop and then rises. As ovulation approaches, there may be a drop in the basal temperature because of an increased production of estrogen. As ovulation approaches, there may be a drop in the basal temperature because of an increased production of estrogen. When ovulation occurs, there will be a rise in the basal temperature because of an increased production of progesterone. When ovulation occurs, there will be a rise in the basal temperature because of increased production of progesterone. So, the changes is sudden, slight increase in the slight drop in the basal temperature before the ovulation, after the ovulation, slight drop in the body temperature. So first drop, then increase. Next question, soft tissue X-ray of the breast is, soft tissue X-ray of the breast is mammoplasty, mammography, mastopexy, cholangiography. Correct answer, mammography. Soft tissue X-ray of the breast is mammography. Next question, what is important for nurses? What is important for a nurse to discuss with a client who just had a vasectomy? What is important for a nurse to discuss with a client who just had a vasectomy? Recanalization of the vas deferens is impossible. Unprotected coitus is safe within 1 week to 10 days. Some impotency is to be expected for several weeks. There must be 15 ejaculation to clear the tract of sperm. The correct answer is, there must be 15 ejaculations to clear the tract of sperm. So, after the vasectomy, the nurse should advise the client that there must be 15 ejaculations to clear the tract of sperm. Otherwise, there is a chance to get pregnant. Some spermatoma will remain viable in the vas deferens for a variable time after vasectomy. Some spermatoma will remain viable in the vas deferens for a variable time after vasectomy. So 15 ejaculation is recommended. Next question, a nurse teaches a client that a postcoital test to evaluate fertility should be performed. A nurse teaches a client that a postcoital test to evaluate fertility should be performed. 1 week after ovulation, immediately after menses, just before the next menstrual period, within 1 to 2 days of presumed ovulation. Correct answer is within 1 to 2 days of presumed ovulation. That is approximately 13th or 14th day of after ovulation, after menstruation. At this time, because of increased estrogen level, the cervical mucus is abandoned and it is quality changes in such a way as to optimize sperm survival time. At this time, because of increased estrogen level, the cervical mucus is abundant and it is quality changes in such a way as to optimize sperm survival time. So 13th or 14th day of the day after the menstruation, the estrogen levels are increased. Because of that, cervical mucus is abundant and its quality changes in such a way as to optimize sperm survival time. Next question, a young man who is being treated for infertility is to have a semen analysis. The nurse explains that this test will. A young man who is being treated for infertility is to have a semen analysis. The nurse explains that this test will. Determine if he is a sexually transmitted disease, he has a sexually transmitted infection. Evaluate for genetic problem. Determine if there are any urethral obstruction. Assess sperm microscopically for number and motility. So correct answer is, assess sperm microscopically for number and motility. The semen analysis is doing for to assess sperm microscopically for number and motility. Usually the number of the sperm will be more than 20 million. Next question, a nurse is counseling a couple in the fertility clinic. Which aspect of the protocol is the most stressful for the couple? a nurse is counseling a couple in the fertility clinic, which aspects of the protocol is the most stressful for the couple? Planning when to have intercourse, obtaining the necessary specimens, visiting the fertility clinic frequently, taking daily basal body temperatures. The correct answer is planning when to have intercourse. A strategy for increasing the chances of conceiving requires the couple to plan intercourse only while the woman is ovulating. This removes spontaneity and is often stressful. A strategy for increasing the chances of conceiving requires the couple to plan intercourse only while the woman is ovulating. This removes spontaneity and is often stressful. Next question. A nurse at the fertility clinic is counseling a couple about the test that will be needed to determine the cause of their infertility. Which test should the nurse describe that will evaluate woman's organ of reproduction? A nurse at the fertility clinic is counseling a couple about test that will be needed to determine the cause of their infertility. Which test should the nurse describe that will evaluate woman's organ of reproduction? Biopsy, cystogram, colposcopy, hysterosalpingogram. Correct answer is hysterosalpingogram. Hysterosalpingogram test enables the examiner to visualize the uterus and fallopian tubes and the pelvic organs of reproduction. The test in a hysterosalpingogram or HSG test enables the examiner to visualize the uterus and fallopian tube and the pelvic organs of the reproduction. Next question. A client who has a diagnosis of endometriosis is concerned about the side effect of hot flushes from her prescribed medication. She tells the nurse that her mother found them very uncomfortable during her menopause. Which medication causes this side effect? A client who has a diagnosis of endometriosis is concerned about the side effect of the hot flushes from her prescribed medication. She tells the nurse that her mother found them very uncomfortable during her menopause. Which medication causes these side effects? Estrogen, leuprolide, diclofenac, ergonovine. The correct answer is leuprolide. Leuprolide is administered once a month via intramuscular injection. It decreases luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone levels as well as hormone dependent tissue. One of its side effects is hot flushes. Leuprolide is administered once a month via IM injection. It decreases luteinizing hormone and follicle stimulating hormone levels as well as hormone dependent tissue. One of its side effects is hot flushes. Next question. At 6 weeks of gestation, a client is diagnosed with gonorrhea. What medication does the nurse expect the healthcare provider to prescribe? At 6 weeks gestation, a client is diagnosed with gonorrhea. What medication does the nurse expect the healthcare provider to prescribe? Ceftriaxone, levofloxacin, sulfasalazine, trimethoprim and sulfamethoxazole combination. Correct answer, ceftriaxone. Ceftriaxone, a broad spectrum antibiotic and is preferred during pregnancy. Ceftriaxone is a broad spectrum antibiotic and is preferred during pregnancy. So questions answer. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe our channel, Dinesh. Thank you.